My name is Matt Turk, and I'm an assistant professor at the School of Information Sciences. I work on understanding how people interact with their data. So data might come stored as a series of zeros and ones on disk. Those might be organized in a certain way that sort of builds up into, you know, numbers or pieces of text or information in some way. And then on top of that, we apply information as we look at or visualize data. We have some sort of understanding of the model that it corresponds to. So in my original research career, I worked in astronomy, and there I would work on simulations of the way that stars formed. We would store all that simulation data on disk in a series of zeros and ones. They would be organized hierarchically, and then we would need to apply, during the course of visualizing or analyzing, we would need to apply our understanding, transform this series of zeros and ones into some sort of cognitive model for a star. And this happens across domains. You might have someone that's studying seismology or the way that oil spills move throughout the Gulf of Mexico, for instance. And the way that those things operate, so in seismology, for instance, the way that rays propagate throughout the Earth and the way that we might want to visualize those, or the way that clumps of oil might break up and disperse and move through in sort of a Lagrangian way throughout the Gulf of Mexico, share a number of very similar characteristics to the way that we see stars forming and the way that we see gas clouds clumping up and breaking. But the way that we address those questions, the way that we ask questions of the data that lead us to this understanding, tends to be very different based on the different fields that people are involved in. And so what my research and in my research group we're attempting to do is attempting to understand how high up that chain of tools, you know, at the level where you're reading things off disk or where you're, you know, processing data, where you're analyzing it, where you're visualizing it, at what point does this domain-specific knowledge need to be taken into account? Can we go really high and share tools across many different communities? Or is there something more fundamental about the mindsets of the different researchers in different fields that might impede sharing tools in that way? One of the reasons that I have found the School of Information Sciences to be my home is that I'm really devoted to understanding how people from across disciplines interact with data, how they value things like understanding and visualizing data, how they interact across disciplinary boundaries, and how we can try to use some of the things from different domains and different fields in order to promote much deeper inquiry across a number of different disciplines and domains.